iOS 26 is here, and with it comes a massive design change, the biggest since iOS 7. But does that make it a huge home run or a gigantic fail? That's what we're going to talk about today. Internet, I'm Brian MacDuff, aka BMac, and welcome to another video. So yes, iOS 26, it is official, it is here, and it's making a splash in good ways and in bad. Because unless you've been living under a rock, you've probably noticed that with iOS 26, there have been a lot of mixed feelings about it. Personally, I think a lot of this is because of how front and center the liquid glass UI overhaul has become. And I think that's kind of sad because despite what you think about the liquid glass UI, there are still a lot of new upgrades and features with iOS 26 that I'm really liking. And so I wanted to talk about what some of those new features and favorite upgrades of mine are, in addition to my honest thoughts on liquid glass UI. So in no particular order, let's just start things out with the new camera app redesign in iOS 26 that is taking a much more minimalistic approach. Everything about the new camera app is cleaner, simpler, and just overall more straightforward to use. You fire up the app and no longer are there a bunch of distracting, sometimes confusing camera settings and elements taking away from the actual capturing process. They've been neatly tucked away to allow for users to focus more on composing the actual shot, while at the same time allowing for all those powerful modes and settings that make the iPhone camera so great to be quickly accessed with just a few quick swipes or taps. I'm loving this. I think it's already implemented and executed so well here in iOS 26, even though we're only at the first developer beta. And I think it's a perfect example of how less can actually be more in app design. But next to the camera app, I'm also loving the new battery and charging upgrades that we're getting with iOS 26. Simple changes that really do go a long way. For example, we finally have a way to quickly and easily see how much time is remaining on our iPhone to charge to a certain percentage using whatever kind of charging setup we currently have. So right now, for example, just a quick glance down at the lock screen is going to show you how much time you have until you reach a charge of 80%, with additional charging times actually being disclosed to you in the battery submenu of settings. So gone are the days where you're going to have to time the charging process, see how long it's actually charging, do the math, and then approximate how long you have to wait until you have enough juice to actually leave the home with your device. It's just a simple little helpful addition to iOS 26 that I think we're all gonna end up using and appreciating. There's also a new adaptive battery mode in iOS 26 that when turned on is gonna automatically make minor performance adjustments to your device, like reducing display brightness or extending the duration of certain activities to extend the overall battery life when usage exceeds the normal level. It's an optional setting that exists alongside low battery mode, so not replacing it, so that the two can now work hand in hand to really push the battery life of your device to the max, giving you as much battery power as possible no matter where your day takes you. After that, I also gotta say, I really appreciate how Apple's implemented their own circle to search functionality here. It's gonna take place through Apple Intelligence's visual intelligence. And what this means is that in true Apple fashion, Apple has added circle to search in iOS 26 in Apple's own way, which is going to be done through a screenshot workflow. If you see something on the screen that you wanna look up, identify, or even just learn more about, you could just simply take a screenshot and then circle the object of interest and then identify it, reverse image search it, or even ask ChatGPT about it, all right from within the screenshot preview window. And when you're done, you could save the screenshot or simply dismiss it to delete it. All of which I do think has already been implemented pretty well here to allow for some pretty cool learning capabilities with whatever it is that's on your display, or even for some note-taking or thought organization. There's also been a few minor changes, but important changes nonetheless, to the Photos app. Changes I actually think are gonna be way more appreciated than it might sound. And that's gonna start off first with the return of a tab bar in Photos in iOS 26. Now that tab bar in iOS 26 is gonna clearly let you switch between your photos and your collections, with that separation in the Photos app allowing for better organization and honestly being a little bit easier to use, or at least somewhat more like it was before iOS 18. A very minor change, yes, but still a change that I think a lot of users are gonna notice and be really happy with. Speaking of minor changes, we might as well cover a few changes that took place within Apple Music. Minor changes, but changes nonetheless that were good ones. I have to first point out how much I appreciate the new music pins category that we now get within our own library in Apple Music. You could pin your favorite artists, albums, playlists, stations, pretty much anything within Apple Music at the top of your library page, kind of like you can in Apple Messages, which is once again a simple change, but one that I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get a lot of use out of, and I think a lot of other users will as well. But perhaps even more than that feature, I think I love the new Auto Mix feature that much more. Using Apple Intelligence in real-time audio processing, AutoMix can time stretch and beat match songs in a playlist to seamlessly mix one song to another, just like a real DJ would. And I will admit that I was a little skeptical with how this was gonna work, but even in beta right now, it's pretty darn awesome. It's not always perfect, and it sometimes does sound a little messy, but it really does do an impressive job of auto-mixing from one song to the next, and it still beats just a simple crossfade. I'll also quickly mention here that there is lyric translation and lyric pronunciation features built into Apple Music now for fans of international music. I'm not listening to a whole heck of a lot of that, but if you do, you'll probably love it. But enough of keeping you waiting, we've gotta talk about it here. The Liquid Glass UI. Love it or hate it, we gotta talk about it. In and of itself, I don't think the Liquid Glass UI of iOS 26 is a bad thing. What I think Liquid Glass needs to be appreciated and embraced are two things in particular. That being beauty and functionality. It's gotta look pretty while also solving a problem or serving a purpose to add to the user experience. Take Safari for example. I think that Liquid Glass actually looks amazing in Safari right now, probably because it's pretty, and because it's functional. It allows for the Safari toolbar to minimize itself and all but hide away when it's not being used, while still remaining and appearing there as a see-through glass-like bar. So in this case, the Liquid Glass UI in Safari has a beautiful look by showing full screen and web page colors shining through that toolbar, while also offering functionality that allows the web pages to appear full screen without a toolbar being noticeably in the way or cutting off the bottom. So there you go, beauty and functionality. You're getting the same thing in Apple Music. You get the Liquid Glass UI and the Liquid Glass UI toolbars to experience a full screen Apple Music app with all of the beautiful album artwork shining through the hovering toolbars, while at the same time remaining there at the ready for when you want to toggle into a different submenu within Apple Music. So again, beauty and functionality. But at any given time, you may or may not have beauty and functionality with Liquid Glass UI, depending on where within iOS you are. And this is where things some of the backlash and negative feedback is coming from. Some areas are just simply not optimized for Liquid Glass yet. There's even what appears to be a wallpaper or a notifications bug right now that doesn't properly dim or shadow the brighter parts of a wallpaper to allow for notifications coming through to actually be seen and read easily. And then, depending on where you are in iOS, you also have the control center, which once you bring that down, could result in a busy, distracting, or just simply hard on the eyes experience with Liquid Glass. These areas and others are where the new UI is prominent, and it has to be optimized there, because if it isn't, beauty and or function takes a hit, and then Liquid Glass seems to become changed just for the sake of change, which isn't always a good thing. The bottom line is that there is a lot of potential with Liquid Glass UI, and I fully understand that it is being presented right now in developer beta form. But without giving this kind of feedback that myself and other users, creators, developers, and testers are providing, whether through the feedback tool or publicly, Apple is not gonna have any guidance on how to improve this beta release. But enough about what I think, what about you? What are your favorite iOS 26 features right now, and how do you feel about Liquid Glass UI? Let me know in the comment section below. I'd love to be able to chime in and chat about it with you guys there. Of course, right down there in the comment section. Leave your thoughts, leave them. But with that element said, I am gonna go keep deep diving into iOS 26, see what other cool little features I could dig up. There's gotta be some more here. There will be some more. And I'll talk about them. I'm gonna have to. There's a lot more to do. But I will see you guys in my next video.